We do this before every show. We do this. We check the temperature to make sure that all of you guys will be comfortable. The aircon is nice. But we realized, we found out, it's very hot. In fact, the exact temperature right now is 98 degrees. So we thought, since the temperature is constantly at 98 degrees, we thought for this show tonight we'll also have 98 degrees. Look at that, we got two girls there from 98 Degrees Fan Club. There you go. Wanna show that? Actually, I should go up there and put my head there. That'll be the degrees. The degrees. So, ladies and gentlemen, I tell you what, let's start this show, shall we? Yeah! Please welcome all the way from US boy band, 98 Degrees. Are you comfortable?
Yeah. Great.
Can we start now? Can we start the show, please? Okay. They love you. What can I say?
They're the best. Yeah, they're great.
And you know what? I think you really make their day. I know you guys are 98 degrees and all that, right? For sure.
You're fake, are you? You're real, right? Okay.
To make that day, I think you guys should introduce yourself, you know, individually, so they like, you know.
Okay.
You want that? You want that? Okay.
Hey, what's up? I'm Justin.
Justin?
Woo! Thank you.
I'm Drew.
I'm Nick.
I'm Jeff.
And together you are
98 degrees.
Okay, this is Saturday night. On Monday, it's going to be Deepavali, so all the Hindus and Indians, happy Deepavali to all of you guys there. And we got a little sweets from the festival, what we eat during this festival. And this is called a muruku.
Muruku.
Muruku. It's very muruku. It's my favorite.
What's the green one?
The green one is sweet. It's very, yeah. Okay. There you go. You got to go for green one? All right.
Jeff?
Nick, the pink one.
What's your favorite?
My favorite is the muruku. That's can I just share with you guys?
Oh, please, don't mind.
I don't think we can share with a thousand of people here, but nice try. Okay, now Jeff. As I understand it, you were the one who got the group together. Did you, at that point, realize that this group was going to be so big, so such a huge success?
Well, originally, I was in a group with some other guys.
Yes.
I went to high school with, and we went out to Los Angeles to pursue the music business or whatever. And then I met a guy that went to school here with Nick and Justin and Drew. And I talked to Nick on the phone, and he seemed really interested, and he sent a tape of his singing to me, and I had never heard anybody sing like that. I thought he was amazing. I was like, you gotta come out, we got all this stuff going on, which we really didn't. I kind of tricked him. And then he came out, and then we got started, and eventually everybody got together out there. And when we first got together, I think the day Drew came out,
yeah,
I mean, we all thought it was gonna be great.
There was somebody else before Drew, wasn't it?
That's right, yeah.
And then he left.
Yeah,
and now he's watching the show and going, where is he now?
He's in LA.
You don't care.
He's delivering food in LA.
He's still delivering food in LA.
He called us after our song hit the top 10. And,
he did.
And asked us if he could come back in the group. And
no!
Yeah.
He did.
But, you know, unfortunately, we had
it's pretty much moved on.
Yeah.
It's four part,
not five.
Well, you know, let's not be mean. Maybe he'll find some other three guys.
We're still good friends with
That's
them,
good. That should be
best.
The way. That Definitely. Should be the way. I gotta say this, Nick. I don't know. Every time I glance this way as I'm answering the question, I keep thinking Val Kilmer. I gotta get one of those done.
This is an experimental phase, you know. Here, this is
the yellow thorn.
Yeah. It's an experiment gone wrong. But, you know.
It's kind of an artistic expression.
Oh yes. 98 Degrees, you got a new album, it's called 98 Degrees and Rising, which I got it right
here.
Yeah! Who did I show it to? Yeah! Who did I show it to? Can I show somebody? Can I show the camera?
There we go!
There you go!
Yeah!
98 Degrees and Rising. Apparently, it has a lot of romantic songs.
Yeah, you
which seems to suggest that you guys a sucker for love songs.
It's true. Yeah, it's true. We're very, very romantic guys, very sensitive guys, and it's true. Yeah, it's true. And so, you know, we had to do an album filled with love songs and very romantic songs that we wrote, and, you know, songs that really came from the heart. So this is definitely a very passionate album, and it really means a lot. We feel like we bared our souls on this album.
Excellent. Okay, the floor managers came to me and go, commercial break. So we gotta go, but we'll still be here. But we're gonna go, but we'll be here.
All right.
But we'll go. You don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with 98 Degrees. Oh, welcome back. This is PWG. During the commercial break, we asked the audience in the studio to give us some questions that they'd like to ask the 98 Degrees, and we've got three of them. Actually, we have hundreds of them, but we only have time for three. Three most interesting ones.
All right.
Which you have not seen, which I have not seen, and I'm just going to read now, and then you answer, just like that.
Shoot.
Question number one. Of all degrees, why 98? Ah.
That's a good question.
That's a very good question.
Why not 97.5? Why not 99? Why not 100? Boiling point.
Well, in Fahrenheit, 98 degrees is body temperature, so it represents body heat and love and passion and
love and passion, steam and heat and
love.
So I got this wrong. I thought it was 98 degrees Celsius, which is like near boiling point, which is also good.
That's another way to look at it.
Both ways.
Exactly. Either way.
Now you know. Okay.
Good question.
Next question, Nick.
Oh man.
Nick Val Kilmer, we heard you had your first on-screen kiss in your guest appearance on City Guys. Do tell us more about the experience. Who did you kiss?
It was actually this actress on the show City Guys named Marissa, who happened to be very beautiful. I just got lucky, I guess. And it was a kissing scene. We're supposed to be dating on the show, and
it was just acting.
And then there's actually. Yeah, she really didn't like me at all, so this was it was the best acting performance of my life.
I always wanted to know, when there's a kissing scene, because I've never done those, and I'm only just doing this and sitcoms and all that, but when you do a movie or a drama and all that, and you know you're going to kiss somebody, do you, like, prepare yourself? Do you go tell a person, okay, let's meet up half an hour before the show starts, and then we'll know?
Practice?
Nick had to get a coach.
I asked her to practice.
Really?
She declined, yeah. She just came up to me and she said, all right, now we're going to have to kiss in this next scene, and don't panic, I'm just going to come up to you and kiss you. I said, I'm not worried about it at all. This is part I've been waiting for. So.
She told you not to panic.
Yeah, so I screwed it up a few times. We had to keep doing it over and over again. And
How do you screw up a kiss?
You should see him
it
do
wasn't
it.
A kiss, it was a...
Okay, demonstrate that.
No, we don't do that.
Okay, next question. This is a serious one. This is like on the emotional, psychological level. It says, will any of you leave 98 degrees like Jerry left the Spice Girls?
You know what? I'm out of here right now.
See you later, man. Come here! Come here!
Sit, Ubu, sit!
I think there needs to be cane for that.
No, well, after the show. No, no, after the show.
No, we're definitely a group, and we started as a group. We've been through so much together as a group, through, you know, many trials and tribulations, and so we want to stay together as a group to see all the good stuff too. So we're definitely going to stay together. Yeah.
Happy? Okay, so these were three questions, and the people who ask this question will give you your T-shirts and your signed T-shirts. 98 Degrees signed T-shirts, yes. Did you write some of the songs
and
the album?
Yeah.
Were they based on real experience, Drew?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, we're romantic guys, like we said before, so we wrote love songs. We wrote a couple up-tempos. We actually co-wrote a song with guys that wrote Invisible Man.
All right.
And it's a great song called Still, and that's a very romantic, emotional song about undying love. No matter what happens in the world, your love is undying.
You know, it strikes me that the four of you guys, you are all passionate about love and women and all that. But when you are in a group like this and you tour around the world, there's no time for all this, is there?
No, unfortunately not. So that's probably why we write about it so much, because we long for it. I mean, we all had girlfriends before we went on tour, but tour definitely takes its toll on relationships. I mean, you can have a girlfriend back at home, but if you're gone for 7 months at a time and you don't get to see her, it's very tough on her, and it takes a lot of trust, and it takes a lot of dedication, and it takes a very strong-willed, strong girl. And it's tough to find.
It takes
a
strong relationship as well.
Yeah, oh yeah, definitely.
Why don't you marry the girl and then... What if you marry the girl and then bring the girl, your wife, with you everywhere you go?
Well, first, the problem is that first you have to find that perfect girl and then have the time to build the relationship, because it takes time to really build a relationship to the point where you're ready to get married. So unfortunately, we haven't been able to do
that. It's not as easy as it sounds.
Yeah, it's a little harder than
that. Yeah, okay. The first song recorded for this new album was this Disney song, True to Your Heart. It's Mulan's theme song. And you had a duet with harmonica legend Stevie Wonder. That must have been like, wow, Stevie Wonder.
We could hardly believe. We just kind of threw it out there. They said, is there anyone you want to work with? We said, well, we love to work with Stevie Wonder, thinking, well, it's probably never going to happen.
Right.
Next thing we know, they're coming back and they're saying, yeah, well, Stevie said he's really interested. He wants to do it. And it was just an unbelievable experience for us, because he's such a legend. He was such an idol and a role model for us.
Yes.
And, we happen to be label mates, too, so that made it even more special. And the whole thing, shooting the video, performing with him live on television, and recording the song, was all just something we'll never forget. Very
Speaking
special.
About performing live, I read somewhere that you guys found your roots in singing a cappella, which is where you guys were from.
Yeah.
So this is a live show. Oh, no. What do you think if we ask them to do some bars from the song True to Your Heart, a cappella? Is that too much to ask? I don't know.
If they want to hear something from us, how can you say no to beautiful ladies like that?
Okay, take it away. Go ahead. Give me a few bars. Give me a few bars. You stand up? Okay. I'll stand all the way.
You just have to find the key.
Okay.
One, two, three.
True to your heart, you must be true to your heart. Baby, shower you with my love. Open your eyes, your heart can tell you no lies. And when you're true to your heart, I know it's gonna lead you straight to me.
Excellent. I got to tell you this. Whenever I hear there's a new boy band that comes up and it's got this single and all this album and all that, I always say to myself, yeah, right, it's all the packaging and all that. They can't really sing, because there are some I've come across in this show. But you guys, man, you are there.
Thanks a lot.
You are there.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's why every boy band that comes here, we tell them, sing a cappella. And they go, oh, yeah. You know? But you guys are cool. We have to go for another commercial break. When we come back, we'll have 98 Degrees. We'll be right back.
A rocket, please.
Huh?
Welcome back, and now we are with 98 Degrees. Okay, let's move on to the next question. You guys shot a music video of your latest hit, Because of You, on top of the Golden Gate Bridge.
Yeah.
I've been on the Golden Gate Bridge. Not on top, but on, and it's like...
Yeah.
And you guys were on top of that. That must have been like, were you tied to the bridge or something?
No.
Unfortunately not. No, the bridge was like 756 feet up in the air, and then there were
more like 7,000.
There were like two towers on the bridge, so right. We had to take like a service elevator up to the top. It takes 6 minutes to get to the top, and it takes 6 minutes to get down. But what was crazy about the elevator? It was small enough for only three people. And they fit Nick, me, and Drew in there together with the guy that ran it, and we were all like this. What's up against each other like this? We're a close group, but not that close, you know what I mean? But
6 minutes of tension.
Yes.
I can just imagine now, you know, four cool guys outside the lift. Yeah. In the lift. Come on, let's sing the song now. Come on, let's go. I know, this is life, isn't it? You never know what hits you. Were you scared?
You know, when you first step out there and you step out and it's this huge open, I mean, you can see for miles and miles and miles, and the wind really is blowing hard, and it's such an awesome sight that you forget to be scared, really. You know what I mean? Yeah. You're looking around, you can see San Francisco, and you can see the mountains and the ocean.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
It's really, really beautiful. Yeah.
But then you remember to be scared.
And then Jeff remembered to remind us.
He reminded us.
I'm afraid of heights, as it is. I don't ride roller coasters. I'm afraid to go up in the escalator in the mall. But being on top of the Golden Gate Bridge was very, very, very frightening. When you go up at first, it was all, you know, it's cool. Oh, this is so beautiful. And then I look down. Whoa, it's really high.
Sing up to the heavens. Right. There you go.
And if you watch carefully, you can see in every shot, Jeff has his hand on the railing very tightly.
Guys, thank you very much. I know you're rushing to the airport, but you still made time to come here. Thanks very much.
Ladies and gentlemen,
8 degrees. Thanks again for 98 degrees, 298 degrees, and next week we have Beatrice Cheer and Deborah Peng from Mail Order Bride, and another homegrown a cappella talent in a court will be with us. And don't forget to join me for the Terry Fox Run Sunday morning, tomorrow morning. It is still not too late to come in the morning and sign up, okay? This is for a good cause because the proceeds go towards cancer research. Want to see you there, you know, a bit of walking and a bit of jogging. But now to take us home, here's 98 degrees in the latest hit because of you. Good night.
I'm losing my mind when you're not around. It's
cure for my pain.